G'day. I wish to express a huge thank you to those of you subscribing to my channel. I see this as something of a partnership, and your subscribing to my channel encourages me, and I trust that the videos I continue to provide are going to be of use to you. This particular video is a response to a particular subscriber who contacted me a week or two ago and asked, "How do you memorise formulae in mathematics?" Well, I realised when I received the message that I hadn't really explained that very well in my How to Study videos. So, WikiMaper, this video is for you and to anyone else out there who wants to learn how to memorise formulae. G'day. Welcome to Crystal Clear Mathematics, where it is easier than you think. I'm your host, Graham Henderson. In this video, we're going to learn some of the principles of memorising formulae. Now, I don't pretend to be an expert. I haven't made a life study of memory or psychology or neurophysiology. I dabble a little in each of those areas, but primarily I'm a mathematician and a teacher. So I'm going to share my personal experience in learning when I was at school and what I've discovered in sharing with students that I tutor. Principle number one is to learn with focus and intention. That is, you choose to learn. And what it means is that you set time aside and you remove yourself from distractions, particularly electronic distractions, anything that will draw your attention visually or audibly away from what you're doing. The benefit of doing that is you will learn faster and better and in shorter time. What I propose to my students is it's far better spending 5 minutes intensive time learning something well than 20 minutes wasted time not learning it well at all. I'd much rather spend 5 intensive minutes and then do 15 minutes of something I enjoy differently. The second principle of memorizing is that it should be memorable. It's interesting we use that word. It should be something that captivates our attention. Now, it captivates our attention because we choose to focus on it. Now, people do this in a variety of ways. There are some very, very good videos on YouTube and some not so good ones where people show how to memorize, for example, the quadratic formula in song. Some people use a melody, that is a very familiar tune or even a nursery rhyme tune, to recall the formula. Others use rhythm, for example, rap. Some people use a storyline and symbology. And if you watch a few videos on YouTube about how to develop your memory, you'll find that there are people who talk about the memory palace and things like that that can be extraordinarily useful as well. All different ways of using your visual imagination or your sense of rhythm or music or some familiar tune or something familiar to you in order to establish this formula in your mind. Another way of establishing it well is to link it to something familiar. Academically, that means you can link it to something historical or you can link it to mathematics that you already know, which is my preferred way of learning, by learning the derivation of the formula. That is going from mathematics you understand and know to the new mathematics and the new formula. The third principle is that in order to establish all this in your memory, it has to be rehearsed intensively in the first week or so. We call this massed practice. What I normally do with my students and what I did myself at school was I would derive a formula once or twice every afternoon for a week or maybe 2 weeks and memorize the formula very rapidly in that way. And the second thing I'd be doing would be using it and establishing its use in my memory. The fourth and last principle is that in order for that knowledge that you gain in that intensive week or two to stay with you for months and months and months until you sit for a major examination, we have to use what's called distributed practice. That is, we have to space out our rehearsal of that understanding in increasingly longer intervals of time, and the best tool for that is using a diary. So what I propose to do now is to talk you through, for example, how to learn the quadratic formula, and I'll be talking about those four principles as we do so. Let's rehearse those four stages or steps or principles again while using the example of deriving the quadratic formula from the quadratic equation. Remember that step number one was to set time aside, to actually be focused and deliberate about your learning. Remove distractions, find a clean sheet of paper, set 5 or 10 minutes aside in a quiet place, and write this at the top of the page. Now, of course, the quadratic equation is y equals ax squared plus bx plus c. For any quadratic equation or any parabola that we're drawing, but to find the roots, we solve y equals 0, which is in fact is the x-axis. So we're finding the position where a parabola will cross the x-axis. That's what the quadratic formula is for. It is in fact nothing more than a rearrangement of this equation, making it very explicit what the x values are. Now, we're going to get from there to the formula by completing the square, and we normally don't like a coefficient other than 1 in front of the x squared. So we'll divide everything by a to get rid of this a. So we get b over a times x plus c over a equals 0 over a, which of course is still 0. Now, we don't know what this value is, and in order to complete this square nicely, we'll remove this to the other side of the equation. I'm going to put it over here. And now we're going to complete the square. To complete this square, we halve the coefficient of x, which is not b on a, but b on 2a, and square it. And of course, if we add it on this side of the equation, we have to add it on the other side. Now that equation is still balanced. This, of course, since we've completed the square, is x plus b on 2a, all squared. There's our x squared, there's our b on 2a squared, and the middle term would be the double the product, twice the product. The product, of course, is bx over 2a, and double it is bx over a. On this side, if I expand this, I have b squared on 4a squared. This term, c on a, if I wish to add to this to make it into one complete fraction, I must make the denominators the same. We cannot add or subtract fractions unless the denominators match. So to make this match that, I have to multiply it by 4a to get 4a squared, which means I have to multiply the top by 4a as well. And that gives me b squared minus 4ac all over 4a squared. Now you can see the quadratic formula starting to take shape. I'll just copy this again. Now we take the square root of both sides. Strictly speaking, the square root of x plus b on 2a all squared is the absolute value of x plus b on 2a. But I'm going to do two steps at once and remove the absolute value and replace it with a plus and minus sign on this side. The square root of that is this, the square root of this is the square root of b squared minus 4ac. And the square root of 4a squared is 2a. We want x by itself, so we remove this term from this side by subtracting it, which means we subtract it from this side as well. I'm going to write it at the front. Plus or minus. And because these do have the same coefficient, I can put them into the one expression. So it's x equals minus b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. And there it is. Now it's a little cramped because I wanted to fit it on the screen. It's taken 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 lines of work, which is not excessive. That's fulfilled our second requirement. We've started with something we knew. We've used a skill that we should understand. And by the way, this will help you practice it. That is completing the square. And using our basic algebra, we've ended up with the quadratic formula. Step number three is to use what we call mass practice. That is, this I would recommend doing at least once a day, if not two, three, four times a day, whichever you feel you're able to do. And as well as that, to use this formula to solve quadratic equations. The more of it you can do over a period of a few days or the first week or so, the better. This is our mass practice. It establishes the concept and the understanding in our mind. The fourth step, once we're confident that we understand it, is to set up a system for distributed practice. That is, for rehearsing this in perhaps a couple of months' time, and then a few months after that, and a few months after that. That requires the use of your diary. And what do I recommend? I recommend you ask those three questions that I've mentioned in another video. Do I understand? And hopefully after your massed practice of doing this derivation and practicing the use of the equation, you do. The second question you ask is, am I fast enough? And again, hopefully, if you've practiced enough, you will be. Of course, if your answer is no to either of these questions, you need to do more massed practice. You need to set more time aside in that week or week and a half to do more examples, to do more derivation practice, so that your understanding and your speed have improved. Once you're confident that you've established those, your third question is, how long before I forget, or how long before I'm unlikely to remember? Now, it might sound funny, but we are very, very good at forgetting. I know of cases where people have been marooned on islands in the Pacific, or have been shipwrecked and helped survive by native populations where the people did not speak the mother tongue of the sailor. Mostly their English stories I'm aware of, but some Spanish and others. And after a few years, they forget their native language. It's quite staggering, something that you would think you would never ever forget. And certainly, it's easy to forget this. So even though you might understand and you might be fast enough, if you want to remember it for an exam in 6 months' time, you must ask yourself, am I confident of remembering it in 2 or 3 months? Try to judge that time carefully and put a note in your diary to recall, to practice this derivation and to do a few more questions before you forget. In most cases, it'll be a matter of a month or two to start with, and hopefully the next time you go through these questions, it'll be 3 or 4 months and then 6 months until this becomes as well established as perhaps Pythagoras' theorem, or even just solving, you know, adding and subtracting fractions or something like that, that you should be able to do very, very well. But there it is. Those four principles. Set time aside and be deliberate. Start with something you know and link it in. Of course, if you can do this with song as well or a story, that's even better. Do your mass practice. Set up your distributed practice with a diary, and you should have no trouble at all remembering your formulae. So there we are. I hope this video has been profitable to you. Please leave a comment Please like the video, and of course I'd be delighted if you subscribe to this channel as well. Thank you very much for watching.